Buenos días. Hello, hello, hello.
How you doing? Good to see everybody out here in this pandemic age. Once again, we're proud to be presenting another episode of the City Lights Walk-Up Poetry Window. Really excited. Hello, sir. How you doing? Nice to see you. Yes, yes, yes. Hello, hello. You ready for some poetry? Some poesia? Some flor de canto? All right. This Sunday, today, I am so excited to have this poeta here. He's coming all the way from Ecuador by way of the Bronx, and he's landed in the East Bay. And now he's here in the poetry window. So y'all give it up. Give it a lot of love to the one, the only, Oscar Bermeo.
South North Beach, great to see all of you for this poesia today. I will start by reading from my new chapbook entitled Público. This is the first poem, How I Start. How I Start. By knowing the problem is not one I can solve through intention and apologies. Apologies and intentions fail in the face of impact on the dignity of this movement. Moments inside a movement of addressing, confronting, realizing I am complicit. Complicit as incomplete, witness standing outside, shadows walking, eyes down, eyes now centered inside, informed. History as informed. Informed practice, practice as unearned advantage, moving forward, around, away, documenting, awakened, aligned, down to amend, ready, resolve, remedy. I know this is a problem. Thank you, my man. Good to see you out there. We dropping some poetry, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah. So, let's see what's up next on the mic. All right. So, growing up in the Bronx in the 80s, it was always a struggle. And so, I remember this one time, just to give you a little bit of history. Is this what happened before the stitches? My best friend and I are just 9 years old. We're on our way back from some adventure in the city. We get off the subway, head out, and hit the hill to go home. The hill is steep and there is no curb. On the way up to the left, there is a thin metal fence with dents and gaps that mark a small cliff with a highway at the bottom. On our right, no barriers, just cars speeding by. There was little room for much of anything, but we still walk shoulder to shoulder anyway. Again, we are 9-year-old boys and know nothing but unearned responsibility minus the burden of consequence. I don't know what I was paying attention to when my best friend tells me, don't look back. Just keep walking the way we are walking. His voice is in serious mode. I heard it before when we were stressed out about a math test or when his dad added another chore before us going out. Or when we were about to fight. We're being followed. If I say go, we need to run, but only if I say go. My gaze is fixed forward, but my eyes are slightly down. I'm looking at our shadows on the asphalt, dark on dark with a thin line of division, but still in harmony. We are marching to the same casual pace. I know that if I hear the word, then we book it uphill. I don't know what happens after that, but I know we're in it together. I wish I could see my friend's expression to get some better sense of what's happening. I know that if I look at his face, then I will turn to see what is following us. I know if I do that, then it starts. I know that if I look back, then I am showing weakness and that we will lose. I know that in the city, there are pigeons, and then there is what eats pigeons. Pigeons maneuver in loose, random ways. They bounce from dried Wonder Bread to spilled fried rice to half-eaten chicken wings to quarter juice boxes. The fragility of their hunger dictates their world. We are stripped of the luxury of casual hunger. We have become intentional raptors, moving against gravity. Reckless, speeding cars continue around us. The fence is an illusion. The cliff remains real. I only have a voice outside of me, ready to say, go. My God. What's left, North Beach? City Lights Poetry, don't forget to come through. Pick up your poetry here from City Lights. Maintain the revolution. Unwanted monuments. In the dark, beneath the bed, with a flashlight by my side, I highlight the page and block out the distractions of the day. Here, between the cool of the linoleum and the dust collecting underneath the web of the box cover spring, I marvel at the figures of comic books, feel the gilded pages of a worn-out encyclopedia, bend the corner edges of a well-rehearsed Bible, flowing with the blueprint of plea and invocation in rhythm and ritual that calls down a Jesus with blue top eyes that glares beyond my words. A Messiah selective in his salvage. I am not sure when I gave myself permission to question this dogma by shuffling the scripts and symbols and stuck with the weight of my anchored accent and thick tongue that holds me close to my original song. A song past the pale Redeemer's grasp. Speech, acknowledgement, acceptance, navigation through pages and apartments, past classrooms and structures, into libraries, parks, and museums. My first tongue twists stiff into weapon to the worship of the written word, then document to statue, to stone, to bring, to hammer. Thank you. What's up, people? Thank you very much, City Lights, for this opportunity just to spit. Much appreciated, especially right, to give this message against the fascism that we are currently experiencing. I know every day when I see the news, I feel I'm attacked. I feel like I am not valued. I feel that I am the person that's being alluded to. I don't like being alluded to. Trump should know better. He's from New York. He knows you don't allude to nothing. You should step up to people and tell them who you are. So this is my little step up to Trump. Acts of change. The heart of Trump's America is looking for a stimulus check that is either there or not enough. Because in Trump's America, they spend time between flat broke and placing the blame on why they are flat broke. In extreme times, they have become familiar with the pain of wanting and little else. Trump's America looks for the news to dull the pain, but the news has lost its nationalist resolve. New numbers are not adding up in Trump's America. This used to be okay. This back and forth between what's true and what's news. Trump's America has always been reality TV, but viewers are dying and ratings are falling. Trump's America needs to feel true again. They hear Clorox can make Trump's America pure, clean, and sterile again. Trump's America's chance to stop the spread of harmful bacteria. Trump's America's deliverance of brighter and longer lasting whites. Trump's America wants medicine, even if the science, the stimulus, the ratings don't add up. Nothing will stump Trump's America from an injection of pure disinfectant, the delivery of light, a powerful concept. There is a need. A deeper science is necessary. A limpieza, a sprinkle agua florida, deep vatarub rub, fog of salvia, slap of chancleta, divinations of Walter Mercado. A good talking to from la tía that tells your chisme right in front of you. These acts of change that only enter the body, ready to let the medicine do the work for the change. Yeah.
Yes, I'm gonna drop.
Deep one. Deep, deep, deep limpieza. Let's see. So again, right, in this current America, in this current press conferences on the daily, where again, my experience, my history, the history of my parents, their work, everything gets constantly erased or constantly put down, I can't help but think, right, like, what day is it gonna happen to me? What day am I gonna disappear? We gotta be ready. You gotta be ready to tell your story, even if it's the last story. Ode to Bones. Simple as alabaster and rigid as bridges, I am tower and trumpet because of your purpose, your vigilance against the atmosphere that would crush all the air from the gristle of my lungs. Pull the weary blood from my arteries. Shear the sinew to reveal your divine architecture. Oh, crossroads of polished tense enamel, uniform geometry of beams, breathing cement and warm marrow. Oh, catwalk of compacted silver, lattice girder that defines my height and imprecision. I look at your model of persistence and find myself inadequate, fragile as the wires that hold my heart. Another mechanical construction, terse in its box grip, apprehensive to relinquish into the habit of loam and limestone. Tender fossil, when the time for headstones and stories arrive for me, when the sweet accident relieves you of the burden of these liquid organs, you will be the proof of my existence. Your rattle and murmur, your brilliant formation, your intersection of stability, your complement of erratic fractures, my final chord. Thank you, North Beach. Hope everybody's enjoying their day out there. And again, thank you for this opportunity to speak out loud. Thank you for this opportunity, as always, to all the poets that came before me that give me this chance. Thinking of my man William Carlos Williams, courtesy of New Jersey. Yeah. Yes, and in the style of William Carlos Williams, a little something, unfortunately, that we're just all a little too familiar with right now. In today's news, 18-year-old Hispanic male shot dead in the streets. No one else hurt in this altercation. Police indicate man most likely armed.
Yeah.
All right. I'm a little bit on the morbid tip right now. I'm really, like, again, right? Like, I have to really think that if there's another 4 years of Trump, that me and my own, the people that I love, the people that have hold me up, whatever's left of us, if there's anything left of us, it's not going to be sincere, it's not going to be legit. So, you know, there's only one way to get ready for death, and you just got to look at it in the eye and say, I see you, I recognize you, and then, hence, like, maybe we can go out and talk a little bit before you got to do what you got to do, right? So, the only way I know to get ready for this political situation is just to talk about death and celebrate the fact that I'm still here. Excavations. If you read the newspapers the right way, Mustang 5.0 have to say their words first. Excavations. If you read the newspapers the right way, you'll find people invent new ways to die every day. The most common one isn't in the papers. Neglect. Most people don't ever get to see their names in print. I'm telling you this because you are still young, which means you don't think it will happen to you. But I can bring you to a cemetery full of people who never thought it would happen to them. I'm telling you this because we can't choose our death any more than we can choose our lives. All we can really do is work hard enough towards a proper burial, says my father. One, internment. Variations are boxed, wrapped or naked, embalmed or otherwise, lying seated or standing, grave, sepulcher, vault, or cairn. Before you drink up, my father says, always spill a little on the sidewalk first. You never know where someone died. All concrete is just one headstone for the city. Two, dispersal through fire, variance, cloth, boxed, pyre, vessel or ship, different procedures adapted to dispose of the ashes. My sister, your aunt, they say she died in her sleep. I know she died in flames. They say she went quiet and in dreams. I know she went out cursing the heat. They say she never felt a thing. I know her skin charred in deep blue light. They say she went straight to heaven. I know she had to first swim up through hell. Three, mummification, variance, salting, mineral baths, dehydration, pitch. El Gordo Pepe ate himself to death. A steady diet of lazy cash and late bills mixed with bad women he called wife too often, and good women he never called back at all. Four, disposal through water. Various include feeding to water animals or fish, disposal in sacred river or sea, boxing, bagging with rocks. Your mother wants me to fix the faucet in the bathtub, the slow leak that I can never fix. I've tried, but every time the rust by the drain reminds me of your aunt. Five, air burial. Various include dismemberment and otherwise ingestion by raptors or scavengers, complete or partial disposal. Pigeons don't leave their young unguarded. They feed their chicks in secret until they grow to adult size. I wish I could protect you like that, keep you safe from going out into those streets, because the streets are constantly torn up. From one day to the next, you never know what condition you'll find the neighborhood in. Why does the city do that? Why the need to tear away all the layers of pavement? City Lights, thank you so much for today. I very much appreciate it. My name is Oscar Bermeo, reading from my chapbook, Publico. Thank you very much. Remember, come inside here, get your own history, get your own information, make up your own facts. It doesn't matter which side you end up on. Just know that you've come up with that information on your own. And the key is right inside here. The books right here is going to let you make that choice that you know is going to bring you right. Thank you, City Lights. Yeah.